New non-invasive way to test for diabetes, a test that can actually predict who might be at greater risk of getting it. Health editor Dr. Maria Simbra has a look at how it works.
To check how your body handles sugar or glucose, we have blood tests to check after a sugary drink and blood tests to check a 3-month span and finger sticks to check moment to moment. Now there are tests to check without piercing your skin, and it can give you information about blood sugar over your whole lifetime, all by shining certain wavelengths of light through the lens of your eye.
That lens, from the time we're born, is crystal clear. Over time, we found that those byproducts of cellular activity can be glucose.
These byproducts stick to proteins in the lens and elsewhere and are thought to cause the complications of diabetes. This optometry office has been offering this non-invasive, FDA-approved test to its patients for a year and a half now, one of the few practices in the area. It's $20 and not covered by insurance, but it can change a patient's awareness of their own risk.
He told me his brother and his sister are both diabetics. He hasn't been to the doctor for a very long time. He was a little bit afraid to go to the doctor. He was a little bit overweight. We did the clear path on him and found that the levels were predictive of diabetic changes, and so that just edged him off to the doctor a little bit faster.
This primary care doctor has not received any reports of this type, but the idea of this additional information appeals to him.
That could be useful because our ability to judge exposure over time or injury over time is limited.
The usual way of detecting damage caused by diabetes is by looking at the back of the eye for damaged blood vessels, a late finding.
The problem is when we see diabetics for the first time, they've often had it for 5 to 10 years, and they can already have complications.
This diabetes specialist says the lens measurements correlate well with a 3-month blood test.
By using this technique, supposedly you can pick up diabetes a lot earlier than blood tests. So it's certainly an improvement over what we have now.
One problem, it's predictive, not diagnostic, and not everyone receives the news of a high reading the same way.
We're not 100% certain these people are going to really develop diabetes. And certain people, when they hear this, they're not too happy about it. And you have to really counsel people that they don't have diabetes. We're trying to prevent diabetes.
I'm Dr. Maria Simbra, KDKA-TV News.